play. You know, when we talk about runners.
And this will be caught at the 30. Touchdown, Detroit. Calvin Johnson, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Lions are able to draw a bit closer.
That's a score you felt they had to have here in the third quarter to get back in this game.
And you know that there was an emphasis on their side. Hey, we know this. We know where we are. But sometimes that binds you up so much that you try too hard, you don't get the score. A perfect combination of urgency, yet relaxed enough to get it done.
The return man is Hill. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. The Madden Elite's offense coming back on the field.
And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here.
White 20!
Again, it's Williams. And he'll be taken down right around the 34 after a pickup of only a yard.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different.
Back now at Ford Field. As we've got the final quarter upon us, we get ready to start the fourth. On third down, Vic. And that is incomplete. Here's Matt Bosher now. And surprisingly, this is the first punt of the game for either team. And it's taken in at the 9. A nice job on the return there, 16 yards. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. And Detroit getting set to go now. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked. But you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
They're throwing to start the drive, but that one incomplete.
There's definitely contact there, but it's the fourth quarter of a kind of tight game, and sometimes the officials just say, let them play. Kind of like your mom used to with you and your brothers, just take the broom to you and send you out to the backyard and tell you to settle it yourselves.
I like that. Yeah, there was contact. I don't know, like you said, enough to warrant the flag. It was close, though.
It's a gain of about 3, but it's going to leave them with 3rd and still 7 yards to go.
Not the start to the drive they were looking for. That run doesn't do much at all.
No, not at all, and it leaves them with 3rd and long, and you know, this is the time of game where these drives really, really start to matter. They've got to make some moves.
He's going to fire one deep. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. It's the former Seahawk, Earl Thomas. And he's able to take this one back to the 36-yard line. They were looking for Johnson that time.
When you're in man coverage, you have help over the top, you become a much more confident defender. Trail the receiver and know that someone over the top can make a play, and that's exactly what happened here. The free safety coming up with the interception.
Throw left side complete. It's Moss. And all the way inside the 15 before they drop him. 23 yards on the play. So it's our visitors with a football as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over.
White 20! Cut!
Now a first down carry. It's Williams. And power running here down to the 6-yard line. So fresh out of the 2-minute warning, and here's another timeout taken with 1:55 remaining. So they come up on 2nd down. If they can get another run like we just saw, would likely put an end to this thing.
White 20!
Now they're going to throw it here with Vic.
And this results in six. Touchdown. Randy Moss with his second touchdown of the afternoon. And that interception key as it leads to the touchdown.
Well, these Madden leads can breathe just a little bit easier now.
I don't think anybody expected this to be as close as it has been.
Yeah, especially not them. I think they expected to come in here and just lay it to them. But I think right now, they're just going to have a little tip of the cap to the other sideline.
Certainly, there's some respect that has been built up in this game. This fielded at the two. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. And Detroit getting set to go now.
Four down. Hey, attack 50 left.
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. He's going to let it fly. And that is going to be caught in one-handed. Wow. Touchdown, Detroit. Calvin Johnson, 71 yards. And the Lions are able to cut into this lead.
No, we're not cheering. No, we're not rooting. But I am excited about this. And I know you are, too. We got a ball game again after that big-time strike.
Big-time strike, and you are right. Don't go anywhere yet. This thing's not done. And they're able to get the connection on the long touchdown pass. And that's one of the easiest drive summaries you'll ever see. One play, touchdown. So here we go. They'll need the recovery, obviously, then a touchdown and a two-point conversion to tie. And this one won't bounce their way. It's covered up by the hands team. And now looking at the clock here, they do have two timeouts. But even if they force a three and out, they're going to have very little time remaining.
So that means they've got to be aggressive and find a way to knock the ball free. They've got to come up with it because they can't just rely, as you noted, on using their timeouts and getting the ball back. They might not have any time to mount an attack, even if they do play it that way. Get the football. That's their mantra.
And we're going to get another timeout called by the Lions. As they'll get it with just over 90 seconds to go in the ballgame. They run it again with Williams. And this carry not as productive. He swallowed up at the line of scrimmage. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. As he'll talk it over here before what'll be an important third down.
By 90.
Vic. Caught left side. It's Beckham. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. The completion good for only six, and that'll bring up fourth.
One hallmark of good defenses is understanding the game, understanding positioning, and tackling immediately in the secondary after catches. I think we just saw that on display right there.
Got to him before he ever had a chance to think about turning it upfield.
Well, this winds up an empty possession. Everything looked okay. He just never got the ball on target. And knowing him, they'll be disappointed with that effort.
Back to throw. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And this will be caught. Touchdown. So in the final minute here, now a two-point conversion will tie the game.
The touchdown's massive, but now they've got to have two to possibly take this to overtime.
All right, now a big two-point conversion attempt still to come. He'll look to throw, and it's caught. And with it, we are tied here in the fourth. Huge, huge conversion there to tie this thing up, but they're not done yet. Their defense needs to get a stop.
Yeah, there's still plenty of time for the other team to come downfield and put some points on the board, but job one was taken care of, the two-point conversion to get this thing tied.
And this return nets positive as he gets past the 25 and up to the 27-yard line. The Madden elites heading back onto the field. They've got work to do, but they do still have a bit of time here.
And they've got to feel comfortable with that, but they have all their play sequences called. they get out of bounds, that allows them to huddle and call another play. But if they don't, it's hurry up to the line of scrimmage and either spike it and stop the clock or continue to move it downfield in order to try and get in range and win this game.
See if they can do just that. And he'll push his way forward to about the 32. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down. Here's Vic. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
Now we're in the situation where the quarterback's got to take full charge of his huddle. Got to totally command and make sure all eyes are on him. All focus is locked in. Going to call multiple plays and go over different situations and scenarios to make sure everyone is on the same page.
And he checks this one down to Williams. It'll be a 3-yard gain, and that'll bring up fourth down.
I think the training and practice broke down on that play because he simply didn't run the route deep enough to get to the first down marker, despite what was a really nice catch and toe tap on the sideline.
Well, it's third down 101. You got to go to the marker, know where it is. Great blocking, nearly sprung in there. 28-yard return. And control of the football, switching hands here with very little time remaining in this contest. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Stafford now to throw. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. And here in overtime, if the team that receives the ball scores a touchdown, it's over. If they don't, we can still have some more football.
That's exactly right. If they go down and kick a field goal, the other team gets a possession to either match it or score a touchdown to win the ball game. If both teams kick field goals, the next team to score wins. But if the receiving team throws a pick six or fumbles the ball and it gets picked up by the defense and they score, the game is...
So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. The Madden Elite's offense trotting out again. They set for their first drive here in overtime, and this is where the crowd can really become a factor.
They've had to battle it all day, but I know what you're saying. In overtime, that gets doubled, doesn't it? At least, because now the crowd really wants to be involved and help their team, and that first drive can dictate the whole thing, because they know if this team takes it downfield and scores a touchdown, it's game over.
It's been loud in here so far. Short gain there to start overtime.
Almost a tester play, wasn't it? Wanted to see if the guys on defense were going to fit the gaps the correct way, because we're in overtime. So it's not just physical tiredness out there, right? Mentally, are you still doing what you're supposed to do? And they were up to the task on that play.
And certainly fatigue on both sides of the football. So a big play in this opening drive of overtime. Now looking at a third and three. They'll try and run for it. Here's Williams. No gain on the play there, and it'll bring up fourth down. Just looking down at this with a naked eye, looks like they have about a yard and a half. Any chance they go for it here?
There's a chance, but I have to say, punt the ball here. Get rid of this thing and try and help your defense a little bit. I know there's that temptation, and I know people have it on their play sheet. I have that one play that'll get me what I need, but if you don't get it, you pretty much handed the game to the other team.
Stafford and the Lions now have it first and 10 at their own 23. On the carry, here's Sanders. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Not much happening there on first down.
I thought there might have been a hole for a split second.
Yeah, but it dried up pretty quickly, didn't it? Closed fast.
21.
Now Stafford with his first throw of OT. He's going to float this, and that's caught inside the 30. And he's into the end zone for the touchdown and the game winner in OT. A partner, a great game that we got to see and making it extra special. Not only did I get four quarters with you in this one, I got some overtime, a little whipped cream on top.
Look at you, trying to make this whole thing palatable.
I just want you to pay for my meal later.
You really just wanted 4 quarters, what you want.